2020 was a year of unusual things, and this is another one of those. But I'm glad to be with you this morning in this way. I want to give a special shout out and thanks to those that have helped lead and worship during my absence. And thank you very much for that. I appreciate that so much. You know, I love Christmas time because the lights, and now I'm talking about not just off my forehead here, but the lights all over the city and in our house and our tree, the great conjunction that we saw in the sky, at least through other lenses. But Christmas has such hope because Jesus came to be with us. And that's the beautiful part of the Christmas message. Our stories, unfortunately, are full of lots of darkness. We're familiar with darkness. And Jesus was too when he came. And that's why we have such a Savior that came and was with us and knows what we go through and what we've been through. And he's been there himself. So our Savior is a marvelous Savior. The Word became flesh and dwells among us. And we're going to celebrate that this morning as we continue a few of Christmas songs. And I invite you to stand in this first song, and after that, you're on your own. But let's stand together and we'll sing the song that says, "Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go." Let's remember what God has commissioned us to do.
Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and Jesus Christ is born. Now shepherds kept their watching o'er silent flocks by night. Who behold throughout the heavens there shone a holy light. Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. Shepherds feared and trembled when low above the earth rang out the angel chorus that hailed our Savior's birth. Earth, go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. Down in a lowly our humble Christ was born, and God sent us salvation that blessed Christmas morn. Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born.
Would you turn to number 133 in the Red Book? O Little Town of Bethlehem. We'll do verses 1 and 4 of this song. Number 133. Lower that.
1, 3. O little town of Bethlehem, how still we see thee lie. Above thy deep and dreamless sleep, the silent stars go by. Yet in thy dark street shineth the everlasting light. The hopes and fears of all the years are met in thee tonight.
Verse 4.
O holy child of Bethlehem, descend to us, we pray. Cast out our sin and enter in. Be born in us today. We hear the Christmas angels, the great glad tidings tell. Oh, come to us, abide with us, our Lord Emmanuel.
Let's pray. O God, come to us in this place today. In these unusual times, we ask that you would pour out your Spirit upon Riverside, upon the churches, that the light may shine forth of this great news of great joy for a dark, dark world. O God, implant in our hearts this desire and this urgency to finish the work that you've given to us, to be the light that shines in the darkness. Thank you, in Jesus' name, amen. Also turn to number 142. Number 142. As with gladness, men of old. And you'll notice that verse 3 especially, and we'll do verses 1, 2, and 3, are bringing gifts. And we're going to be thinking about that a little bit this morning as Pastor James brings some thoughts to us about that. Number 142. Oops, wrong key.
As with gladness men of old did the guiding star behold, as with joy they hailed its light, leading onward beaming bright. So, most gracious Lord, may we evermore be led to Thee. As with joyful steps they sped to that lowly manger bed, there to bend the knee before Him who heaven and earth adore. So may we with willing feet ever seek Thy mercy seat. As they offered gifts most rare at that manger rude and bare, so may we with holy joy, pure and free from sins alloy, all our costless treasures bring, Christ to Thee, our Heavenly King. Amen. Amen.
James has asked me to lead the song, A Little Drummer Boy. But before we do that, this song, I think, connects to the theme that he's going to pull out of that song, in that, what do we bring to Jesus as a gift, as an offering? And this song, Heart of Worship, says, longing just to bring something that's of worth, that will bless your heart. The little drummer boy didn't have much. What do we have? Do we have a heart of worship? I think that is what we can bring this morning.
When the music sick fades and all is stripped away, and I simply come, longing just to bring something that's of worth, that will bless your heart. I'll bring you more than a song, for a song in itself is not what you have required. You search much deeper within, through the way things appear. You're looking into my heart. I'm coming back to the heart of worship, when it's all about you. It's all about you, Jesus. I'm sorry, Lord, for the thing I've made it. When it's all about you, it's all about you. The King of endless words, no one could express how much you deserve. Though I'm weak and poor, all I have is yours. Every single breath, I'll bring you more than a song, for a song in itself is not what you have required. You search much deeper within, through the way things appear. You're looking into my heart. I'm coming back to the heart of worship, when it's all about you. It's all about you, Jesus. I'm sorry, Lord, for the thing that I've made it. When it's all about you, it's all about you, Jesus. I'm coming back to the heart of worship, when it's all about you. It's all about you, Jesus. I'm sorry, Lord, for the thing that I've made it. When it's all about you, it's all about you, Jesus. It's all about you. Ba-rum-pum-pum-pum. A newborn king to see. Ba-rum-pum-pum-pum. Our finest gifts we bring. Ba-rum-pum-pum-pum. To lay before our king. Ba-rum-pum-pum-pum. Rum-pum-pum-pum. Rum-pum-pum. Ba-rum-pum-pum-pum. When we come, little baby, ba-rum-pum-pum-pum. I am a poor boy too, ba-rum-pum-pum-pum. I have no gifts to bring, ba-rum-pum-pum-pum. that's fit to give our King. Pa-rum-pa-pum-pum, rum-pa-pum-pum, rum-pa-pum-pum. Shall I play for you? Pa-rum-pa-pum-pum. And lamb kept time, ba-rum-pa-bum-bum. I played my drum for him, ba-rum-pa-bum-bum. I played my best for him, ba-rum-pa-bum-bum, rum-pa-bum-bum, rum-pa-bum-bum. Ba-rum-pa-bum-bum, me and my drum, me and my drum, me and my drum, me and my drum.
Well, I'd like to welcome you once again to our virtual service, and wishing you a Merry Christmas, even though it's belated. I'm wishing you a Happy New Year, even though that's ahead of time. We're in this middle range part here. And thinking about a message and what to speak on, and it just can't get something out of my heart to share with you. So I can't help but think about past Christmases for me. I used to love to pull out one of my mom and dad's Christmas records and listen to it. Remember the 33 records, and you could pile three or four on the stereo on the record player, and you can listen one right after the other. I can remember Mom pulling out Handel's Messiah. She had three or four records of them, and to listen to her or watch her listen to the Hallelujah chorus. And of course, I had to do that again, and just reminded me of Mom and listening to the choruses. But there's another song I liked as a kid and I still like today, and I went and looked it up, and I have it on a CD now, and I put it in my car when I went for a ride to see the lights the other night, played it, and it's a song that isn't a for real song for Christmas, but it still has a really good meaning. And I can remember as a kid going to bed singing this song. And, oh, you've heard of it, The Little Drummer Boy. And they told me, ba-rum-pa-bum-bum. So I looked up the lyrics of that song. So I had them in front of me. And you know, it's funny how you remember things as a kid. I can remember the song. I can picture a boy playing a drum and everything else. But there isn't very many words to the song. There's a lot of rum-pa-bum-bums in this song, and I never thought about that until I put the words in front of me. But I still like to talk about the words and just share a little bit about the words and why I just felt led to talk about this song. And realizing the meaning of it has a lot of meaning, but the song is kind of fictitious in a sense. It's talking about this little boy comes on the scene, and I'll just pick it up here. It says, come they told me, ba-rum-pa-bum-bum, a newborn king to see. So he apparently somehow he heard about this new king that was born in a manger, and he was invited to come see it, and he went to go see it. And it says, come they told me, a newborn king to see. And then when he gets there, he recognizes that there's people giving gifts, at least according to the song. And it goes, our finest gifts we bring, pa-rum-pa-bum-bum, to lay before the king. So to honor him, we come. And he got caught up into the moment, and he was sitting there watching these other people giving gifts. And he said, wow, I'm experiencing a tremendous thing here. And when you think about it, If you allow your imagination to go a little bit, last week's Sunday school lesson was on the shepherds being able to see angels while they were out tending their flocks at night. The next thing they see, this glory shine around about them. And not only did they get to see the glory, the angel told them in the city of David, there's a Savior that is born who is going to be King and Lord. And the next thing they know, this whole heavenly host is singing glory to God in the highest. And if you could just picture, if that boy was there, if you could just picture these shepherds sitting there, wow, what are we experiencing? And we haven't even talked about the Bethlehem star yet. And them shepherds go and see this baby in Bethlehem, and they did find a baby, and they did find a baby in a manger, and they did find him wrapped in swaddling clothes. And then they decided to leave, and they started telling everybody in the countryside what happened to them that night, and rightfully so. Would you not tell somebody you saw an angel? Would you not tell them you seen this glory that's shown around about you? Would you not go tell somebody that you just saw and heard a heavenly choir singing glory to God in the highest? And somehow this boy got wind of it. And this boy shows up at the manger scene and says, these people are giving gifts. And why he's at the manger scene, he's watching from a distance. He's looking at this little baby, ba-rumpa bum bum. I'm just a poor boy too. Ba-rumpa bum bum. Just like he was in a manger. He said, I have no gift to bring. He's seen all these other people giving their gifts. And he said, I got no gift to bring that's fit for a king. And then he realizes he has his drum with him. And he has his drum and he said, you know what? Mary, if it's all right with you, can I play my drum for him? And she nodded, yes. That's how the song goes anyhow. And you know the song's fictitious because the next line says, Mary nodded and the ox and lamb kept time. That would have been interesting to see. But I like, just bear with me. And he said, I'll play my drum for you. That's all he had. He was just a young boy. He said, I'll play my drum for you. And then he said, you know what? I'll not only play my drum for you, it says, ba-rum-pa-bum-bum, I'll play my best for him. And then when he got done playing, it says, then he smiled at me. Come, they told me, a newborn king to see. Now, some of you are probably sitting there saying, James, that's a kid's Christmas song. But I really like the song because it says something about our relationship with God. Sooner or later in your life, if you haven't already, you're going to come, somebody's going to tell you to come to Jesus in some size, shape, or form. And they're going to invite you to come to see a newborn, to see a king. And they're going to tell you his name is Jesus. And when you come and you hear about this Jesus, you're going to have to decide what you're going to do with them. And Jesus' whole reason for coming into the world was to seek and to save the lost. And he provided a way for our sins to be taken care of. And when we come to him and we decide to accept his gift of sacrifice for our sins, and we realize that he paid an incredible price for our sins on the cross later on, this is the enjoyable side of Christ coming down from heaven and leaving his splendor and glory. But the more not so nice side is when he went to the cross, even though that's a glorious side because he loved us so much he died on the cross for our sins. Now we're going to come to him, and what we do with Jesus makes a world of difference. If we accept him in our hearts, we accept the forgiveness of him for his sins, now there comes another part in our lives. We're in the presence of the King. We accepted his gift to us for the forgiveness of sins. And what do you do when you're in the presence of the King? What do you do when you're in the presence of somebody that's given you so much? You want to give something back, just like the little boy did. The little boy didn't have anything. The little boy says, "Can I just play my drum for you? It's the best I got." And then he played his best for him. Is that no different than you and I? You and I get the privilege to have our sins forgiven. Now we get the privilege to turn around and say to God, "God, you're my king now. And I want to bear gifts to you. I want to come to you and give you something in return." I read this in a book and I really liked it. It said, "Lord, please give me the desire to live and work for you as an outlet of my love and gratitude for you." What it's really saying is, I want to give a gift back to you, Lord. I want to play for you, Lord. Lord, I don't even want to, and I want to explain that play part eventually here. I don't want to just play for you. I want to play my best for you. I want to do my best for you. And just like that boy played his drum for him, and our gifts can range in so many different ways. You take today, you're listening to me speak, and some would say, that's my gift. And Paul is going to put together worship time. That's his gift. But all of us have gifts in different size, shapes, or forms. And how are we playing for him? The little boy played his drum. And I hope you can see this. I put it on here. We get the privilege to play our life for him. If there's something that tickles God's fancy, so to speak, that really gets God's mind. And remember in this story here, it says that, and I played my drum for him. I played my best for him. And then he smiled at me. And I realized he was a baby in a manger. But at the same token, God smiles in heaven when he sees those that have accepted him as king of their life, ask for the forgiveness of sins, and they turn around and want to live for him. And God is just smiling. And I'm sitting here and I'm preparing this message and I'm saying, I haven't put any scripture in this. And scripture is way more important than what James Schlegel's got to say. And I couldn't get this scripture out of my mind. And I'm in Job chapter 1. And I just want to read Job. It says, "In the land of Uz, there lived a man whose name was Job. And this man was blameless, upright. He feared God and shunned evil. He had 7 sons, 3 daughters, and he owned 7,000 sheep, 3,000 camels, 500 yoke of oxen, 500 donkeys. It had a large number of servants, and he was the greatest man, among all the people of the East. His sons used to take turns holding feasts in their homes, and they would invite their 3 sisters to eat and drink with them. And when a period of feasting had run its course, Job would send and have them purified. Early in the morning, he would sacrifice a burnt offering for each of them, thinking, 'Perhaps my children have sinned and cursed God in their hearts.' This was Job's regular custom." This was Job's regular custom. He would pray for his children and offer sacrifices in case they had done some things that wasn't pleasing to God. But I think that custom goes a little bit deeper than that, because it says Job was a blameless, upright, and he feared God and shunned evil. He was a man that was playing his life for God. He was playing his drum for God. And look at this, folks. If you jump down to verse 8, Satan, for some reason, come into the presence of God, and God has this big smile on his face. He says, "Have you considered my servant Job, Satan? There's no one on earth like him. He is blameless, upright, a man who fears God and shuns evil." God was excited to brag about him. Now, a lot of things happen in Job's life later on that isn't very pleasing, isn't very delightful, but he still played his life for him. He had a lot of questions. He had a lot of unanswered questions. He had a lot of heartaches. Come on, folks, let's be honest. We have heartaches. We have a lot of unanswered questions. We have a lot of things that don't go the way we exactly like them. But Job kept playing for him, because he wanted to live a life that pleased God. He didn't understand it all. He was fortunate. He got all the things he lost in his life back again. But he made a custom. If I can expand on that just a little bit, he made a decision that I want to play for God. I want to live for God. And he worked at it. Folks, I know the Drummer Boy song is a fictitious song. But it's a fictitious song with a deep meaning. It invites us to come to the King we're told about. And a lot of us, we've been told about the King. We've been told about what he's done for us. And we get the privilege this time of year to celebrate at the beginning of his coming. In a few months, we get to celebrate the end of his coming, or the beginning of his leaving, or his beginning of preparing a home for us. And I think it's important for you and I to once again take a look at, am I playing my drum for the King? Am I living for the King? Is he smiling at me? I'm not asking us to look at ourselves and condemn ourselves. I'm just asking us to assess and ask God, am I pleasing to you? And not only am I playing my drum, not only am I living my life for him, am I giving my best for him? Whatever that may mean for each and every one of us. Let's pray. Lord, I am so thankful that you came for us. You were a king in heaven. You came as a lowly baby. You eventually died on the cross that our sins could be forgiven and we could someday live with you in glory. But right now, Lord, we're living in this world, Lord, and help us to have a desire in our hearts to want to play for you. To live a life that you're smiling down on and saying, Satan, do you see this one? Do you see this one? Lord, enrich our desire to live a life that's pleasing to you, and a desire to want to play, and not just to play, but to play our best. And I just pray this in your name. Amen. See you in the new year.
Empty hands held high, such small sacrifice. If not joined with my life, I sing in vain tonight. May the words I say and the things I do make my life song sing, bring a smile. songs sing.